A while back, I reviewed Lenovo Yoga 7i 2-in-1 convertible laptop. I really liked that laptop, and in fact, I rated it as the number one choice in my pick of 2-in-1 convertible laptops. So today I've got with me its bigger brother, the Lenovo Yoga 9i. Think of this laptop as the big macho version of Yoga 7i. In today's video, I will give my thoughts and first impressions of Yoga 9i. Now let's get the obvious question out of the way. Why would you pick Yoga 9i over Yoga 7i? If you want a relatively thin 2-in-1 convertible 360 laptop with specs that go toe-to-toe with a gaming laptop, Yoga 9i is the answer. This laptop is packing the guts of an absolute beast in a 2-in-1 convertible 360 form factor. So I would say that Yoga 9i sits between a bulky gaming laptop and a thin and light 2-in-1 convertible laptop. Added bonus is that Yoga 9i supports an active stylus pen and has a multi-touch display. So it's great for folks who do creative work like digital art, taking handwritten notes, and also pushing their laptops for running demanding tasks like video editing and gaming. If you happen to fall in this category, Yoga 9i is the perfect laptop for you. Let's quickly go over the specs. My review unit here is rocking an Intel Core i7 H series processor and NVIDIA GTX 1650 Ti Max-Q GPU. It's packing 16 GB of DDR4 RAM and 1 TB of PCIe NVMe SSD. I think these specs are pretty impressive for the form factor. Honestly, I have never used a touchscreen 2-in-1 laptop that supports active pen and also packs a discrete NVIDIA GPU and a high performance Intel CPU. Now the base model of Yoga 9i will cost you around $1,300, but the version that I have with me will cost little more. It's about $1,600 to $1,800 depending on where you buy it from. Unfortunately, I cannot give you the exact price because it's fluctuating a lot, and this is largely because of, you know, the shortage because of pandemic. So please check the links that I've put in the video description below to find the latest price on various configuration of Lenovo Yoga 9i. Apart from the specs, the premium build quality of Yoga 9i has impressed me the most. This laptop is using an all-metal construction with precise craftsmanship. Its chassis is rock solid and you won't notice any bending or creaking. The corners and edges of this laptop are crafted to perfection. When you close the lid, there is zero gap and the whole unit feels like a premium unibody machine. The 360-degree hinge is all metallic and it feels rock solid. The palm rest is made from aluminium and it feels very comfortable while typing. As far as typing experience is concerned, I think it's top-notch. And that should not come as a surprise because its younger sibling, the Yoga 7i, also delivered a great typing experience. Keyboard is backlit enabled, but unfortunately you're not getting any fancy RGB lighting, you know, the kind of lighting you get in gaming laptop. Okay, moving on to the touchpad, you're getting a premium glass touchpad. It's smooth and feels perfect when scrolling and swiping. The only negative thing that I can say about this touchpad is its size. I would have preferred a larger surface area, especially since this is a big laptop and there is no shortage of real estate. I really like how Apple puts large touchpads on their MacBooks, and I wish Lenovo copies that design philosophy. Right next to the touchpad is a fingerprint sensor, which is always handy for quick passwordless login. Okay, now let's talk about the display. So you're getting a vibrant full HD 15.6-inch touchscreen display that supports HDR and looks really amazing when watching videos and playing games. As I mentioned before, the screen fully supports Lenovo's active stylus pen. Lenovo has included a pen with Yoga 9i, and this pen nicely tucks underneath the laptop. It's a little small for my preference, but since it's tucked right under the keyboard, I find it very handy. For taking long notes or making digital art, I would still prefer the larger Lenovo Active Pen. I find those pens more comfortable and ergonomic because they are bigger and they are fatter, and I have long fingers, so you know, I find tiny pens very uncomfortable. The good news is that all Lenovo Active Pens are compatible with this laptop. So if you are thinking of getting one, I have linked compatible pens in the video description below. Now when it comes to using these Active Pens on Yoga 9i, the writing experience is really good. I did encounter some issues with palm rejection, but it turned out to be the default software setting. Once I selected the ignore finger touch while using the pen option in pen settings, you know, the palm rejection issues were resolved and it worked flawlessly. Of course, I will do a thorough review of this pen in my full review, but I did doodle and took some quick notes. My first impressions were identical to Yoga's 7i. And honestly, I won't be surprised if Lenovo is using identical screen digitizer in both these laptops. Now, the large display size coupled with 4.4 pounds of weight makes Yoga 9i an inconvenient tablet. It's just too large and heavy to hold in your hands in tablet mode and take notes. I would assume that Yoga 9i is more useful for taking occasional notes and doodling. So if you're a student who is taking notes while your professor is giving lectures, I think you will be fine if you are seated in a classroom and if you have a table. But smaller and lighter laptops like the Yoga 7i or Flex 5i, I think they are more convenient for students. Moving on to the ports, this laptop comes with two USB Type-C ports that support DisplayPort 1.4 protocol. So that means you can have up to three independent displays, the native laptop display and two external monitors. Please note that Lenovo has skipped the HDMI port, which really sucks. Now, USB Type-C ports are fine, but most monitors come with only HDMI and DisplayPort. So that means you will need a USB Type-C hub to connect this laptop to an external monitor. You're also getting one USB Type-C 3.0 Type-A port and a headphone microphone combo jack. But that's it. No other ports. So that means no SD card slot, no micro SD card slot, and no Ethernet port. Let's talk about the battery. So Yoga 9i is using 69 watt hour battery. It supports rapid charging, and according to Lenovo, you can get 2 hours of runtime with only 15 minutes of charging. Of course, I will test these claims in my full review. Regarding the battery life, Lenovo is making some audacious claims. So they are quoting 14 hours of battery life while playing 1080p video in a loopback mode. Now, these are very impressive numbers considering that Yoga 9i has a discrete NVIDIA GPU. Honestly, I'm a little skeptical about this battery life claim and would be very interested to test it in real world use. Overall, I'm really looking forward to testing out this laptop. In the meantime, here are my first impressions. Yoga 9i should appeal to folks who want a 2-in-1 convertible laptop with 360 degree hinge and an active pen support without compromising on performance. Now, most gaming laptops are too bulky and they don't come with a 360 hinge and they never support an active stylus pen. So I think Yoga 9i is a very unique laptop. Now, like I said before, I will do a full thorough review of this laptop. So if you are not subscribed, please do so. In the meantime,